great opportunity for our children in the future to actually look back at this day, let's be momentous about it, look back at this day as the start of us having power in the North, which I, for one, am more than supportive of. So all I would ask the party opposite, again, who I have the greatest respect for, that if you start making partisan points going forward, then clearly we're not going to get very far. This is about something more important than party politics. This is actually about the future of the Wirral within the Greater Merseyside. Thank you.
Thank you, Councillor. Councillor Jerry Ellis.
Well, Mr. Mayor, it's with great sadness that I have to support this motion, as I will support it, but I really fail to put that in the end. Why do you know that? And a number of things I don't like about it. I don't like the thought of being part of the Greater Merseyside. I would have thought that the river is a barrier, and it's directly guided by me, and I would have loved to have been there, joining in with Chester.
Twice already this evening that, you know, you may have to look at the comments from the electoral. Reform Society yesterday, the whole people on Merseyside and the elected mayor, and nobody, absolutely nobody was asking what do you want, you know? So we've got to make sure, as elected members, representing those people, that we can actually get the best that we possibly can as we move forward. It's a suggestion that we're putting forward, and I think it's a good one. It should be supported, and it should be supported by all parties. I've already heard that the leader doesn't agree with that. He did use the analogy it's going to cost an extra, you know, arm and a leg. I like to think the arm and the leg is already gone, because while we were going through the whole process of what we're going to receive with this devolution act, we actually ended up with less funds than we had before we became Objective 1 funded and in the European capitals. That's a huge amount of money. The figures have already been set by the elected members. I don't have any more to add than that, Mr. Mayor. I think it's an excellent amendment. Looking forward to the future, that's what we've all got to do. We've got to look forward to the future. Not for us, for the children and the people behind us. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Councillor Mitchell. Can I have the seconder of the motion, please? Councillor Mitchell.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Mr. Mayor, when we held a debate on this matter in July, we reflected on the opportunities that a combined Northern Powerhouse would bring to Wirral from the Liverpool City region. What became clear as the discussions on a devolved deal for Merseyside began to move at a pace was that the opportunity to realise powers and resources for us was a very limited window, and that doing nothing was not an option. We owed it to those that we are elected to represent to get the best possible deal available. This whole issue, however, Mr. Mayor, must be set in the context of taking some control and being in charge of our own destiny, instead of having cuts and responsibilities imposed on us. In this regard, I mean the slashing of budgets, with £151 million already gone from the budget in this borough, and another £126 million to go, that's £275 million by 2020. The abolition of the rate support grant coming soon will see the basic prop of this authority removed, and the prediction for business rate retention is set to see this council be a net loser of £6 million a year, as opposed to Tory Westminster, where there will be millions and billions of pounds for them in retained business rate. Spending less and economising, Mr. Mayor, are second nature to us, but the need to attract more resources and grow our way to a sustainable future is clearly vital. When we had a look at the Manchester deal in October last year, we did so from the perspective of how will those powers and resources help us to deliver for Wirral. And taking that pragmatic approach is very much a key overriding driver in terms of the deal before us this evening. No one would want to try and dress this up as a Tory government reversing its slash and burn policy towards local government. In fact, we are right to be sceptical and on our guard as to what those powers may mean. The responsibilities we take are a phased and staged approach, together with learning the lessons of our near neighbours' experiences, will stand us in good stead as we go forward. We are very clear that making decisions at a local level about issues that affect our communities in every aspect of daily life is the place where we want to be. To regulate services like buses, to ensure residents get to work on the Mersey Rail network on faster, efficient trains and through the tunnel at a cost determined by us and not Whitehall, have got to be better in anyone's book. We believe the people of Wirral, Mr. Mayor, elected all of us to do the very best we can to help to ensure that a good quality of life for all, and that we would see that in terms of our young people being skilled for jobs that we can help to create through a Pan-Merseyside growth agenda, and where families can thrive and enjoy good quality of life, and we intend to deliver on that. As a democratic organisation who take collective responsibility for decisions, our position on the Metro Mayor has also been clear. We do not wish to see so many powers vested in one person. That's why we're clear that checks and balances on the Mayor and Executive will need to be robust, open and transparent. Two-thirds majority in general for the Cabinet decisions and sovereignty of the six councils to make decisions about matters of direct concern to their own residents are key and important issues that will need to be worked out very quickly. We must, however, be careful, Mr. Mayor, that we keep the structure straightforward, and whilst allowing for scrutiny, that we do not create a bureaucracy which the public would feel makes decisions far removed from them. We have a Wirral plan, and we are committed to delivering our pledges under that plan in partnership with our public, business and third sector partners here in Wirral. This devolution deal can only help to enhance our ambitions and accelerate the delivery of our pledges around jobs, skills, growth and quality of life here. It must be seen in the round as part of an agenda for the North, which is being led, Mr. Mayor, by Northern Labour councillors, not the Chancellor, which begins to rebalance the UK economy and the overheated south of England. It's about freedoms and flexibilities. It's about beginning to take control and shaping our own agenda. It would be remiss of me, Mr. Mayor, in closing, if I didn't pay tribute to the hard work, commitment and sheer determination of the Leader of the Council, Phil Davies, in making this happen. I know you will say, Phil, this is a team effort, but deals like this happen because of credible leadership. And I know you've driven a hard bargain in terms of the offer from government along the way, and have been at the forefront of the negotiations, which ensured we have the same financial deal as Manchester. Our thanks should also go to our Chief Executive, Eric Robinson, who has been involved in the detailed work and planning, and who is a key component of that very solid leadership team from Wirral on this agenda. Mr. Mayor, in closing, let's start on the journey now with our eyes wide open and embrace the opportunities before us. I urge the Council to vote in favour of accepting the devolution deal as set out in the Chief Executive's recommendations. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Yeah. So the reality is, Mr. Mayor, that no, it's not the ideal deal, but it is a substantial amount of additional funding for those key services that we need. I've kind of said just on the Northern Powerhouse. Yeah, it's a great soundbite and a great concept. But what has actually been delivered so far? The Trans-Pennine rail upgrade has been rushed. Okay, it's going ahead, is it? Great. But the reality is. This Northern Powerhouse is anything more than a George Osborne soundbite. I hope I'm wrong. The reality is, George, I think the Chancellor did get it wrong. I stand by that. I think it is absolutely outrageous to force one governance model, i.e. Metro Mayor, on us and the other city regions. How can that accord with any notions of localism or allowing local people to decide what's best for them? So I stand by that. On the governance issue, I agree with Jeff on this one point, that it does need to reflect the plurality within the city region, and I will definitely take that back to my colleagues. But I'm sorry, I can't support a London-style assembly with 51 elected members. And Jeff actually said he thought bits of the Lib Dem resolution was barking mad, but he's going to support it. So I get the principle about collaboration, but I think it's a shame that the Lib Dems came with this specific proposal, which I'm sorry, I repeat, I would rather spend that 2.8 million that we spent on jobs and investment and skills in our local residents. So, Mr. Mayor, I do think this pragmatically is the right decision for us. I think, as Anne McLachlan quite rightly said, it will definitely help us deliver our 2020 pledges around jobs, skills, investment, housing, and so on and so forth. And it will enable us for the first time to do much more locally than we have hitherto. I absolutely repeat that this is a journey on devolution, and there will be a second phase and probably a third and fourth phase, and we need to get more on the table. But I repeat, I would be failing my duty as leader of the council if I didn't get the best deal I can within this very narrow window of opportunity around the comprehensive spending review. A timetable not decided by me, not decided by the Labour group, but decided by the government. That was the deadline that they gave us. And I would ask every member of this council to examine their consciences and say, if you say no to this deal, how can we justify that to our electors? How can we justify that? I don't think there's any defence for that. So there are reservations, but I think this will give us benefits. That doesn't take anything away from the campaign I think we need to continue to do, or the argument we need to continue to make about the unfairness of the way local government budgets are being cut. And I really fear for what else is going to come out of the comprehensive spending review. But I think this is a good deal for Wirral, it's a good deal for our residents, and I ask everybody to support it. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
I'll be taking the amendment first. So, can I have
a call vote, Mr. Mayor?
That's a call vote on the amendment.
Thank you. Against.
Councillor Fielder.
Against.
Councillor Fielder.
Against.
Against. Councillor Fielder.
For.
Councillor Ellis.
For.
Councillor Fabs.
Yes.
Councillor Fraser.
For.
Councillor Gilchrist.
For.
Councillor Green.
For.
Councillor Gregson.
Against.
Councillor Haggett.
Against.
Councillor Hale.
For.
Councillor Johnson.
Against.
Councillor Adrian Jones.
Against.
Councillor Chris Jones.
Against.
Councillor Kenny.
Against.
Councillor Hughes.
Against.
Councillor Alan Patrick.
Against.
Councillor Warren Cockle.
Against.
Councillor Beaton.
Against.
Councillor Mitchell.
For.
Councillor Mooney.
Against.
Councillor Musbrush.
Against.
Councillor Nidlock.
Against.
Councillor Broadbury.
Against.
Councillor Patrick.
Against.
Councillor Pilgrim.
For.
Councillor Rhys Jones.
Against.
Councillor Rennie. Councillor Roberts.
Against.
Councillor Lawrence. Councillor Salter.
Against.
Councillor Jackson.
Against.
Councillor Waterston.
Against.
Councillor Spriggs.
Against.
Councillor Stapleton.
Yes.
Councillor Sullivan.
Against.
Councillor Sykes.
For.
Councillor Lodge.
Against.
Councillor Cox.
For.
Councillor Whittingham.
Against.
Councillor Williams. Councillor Jerry Williams.
Against.
Councillor Pat Williams.
For.
Councillor Steve Williams.
For.
Councillor Williamson.
Against.
That's 24, 39 against and 2 abstentions. That's clearly lost. So moving to the substantive motion.
Councillor Matt Daniel.
For.
Councillor Mitchell.
For.
councillors, this is quite an historic moment. 4-59, one against and one abstention. Congratulations. On page 33 of the agenda, PAC and the recommendation of the Cabinet on 5th of November, minute 72, car parking charges.
Just a little point of order. Should that, so we talked about the introduction of free park, should that not be the reintroduction?
To the crime provisers about common law, and hopeful that this causes such a vibe against this next year.
Thank you, Councillor. Councillor, do you say what?
Second.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I'd like to second this amendment. Since January, I've been a member of the Burnham Improvement District Steering Group, which is run by the Lord Chairman of Commerce. The group comprises representatives from public, private, and charitable sectors and was established by the Chamber to develop a bid in an effort to regenerate Brentham Town Centre. Throughout my time working with the Chamber on this initiative, it's become apparent just how important a thriving small business community is, not just to Birkenhead, but to Wirral as a whole. Small businesses are the foundations of the local economy, and it's therefore only right that as a local authority we should recognise the contribution small businesses make and support them in any way possible. Wirral Chamber of Commerce and a team behind Birkenhead Bid will be championing the Small Business Saturday Initiative, and I believe the local authority should also support the cause. Small Business Saturday is a grassroots campaign which exists to support, promote and inspire small businesses. On the first Saturday in December, there will be a whole host of events across the United Kingdom aimed at highlighting the importance of small businesses. One method of support being offered by other local authorities who are backing the scheme is a reduction in parking charges for the day. Small businesses are often concentrated in areas outside the central business districts and feel parking charges discourage footfall and passing trade. I'm delighted that they're going one stage further and making it through. I believe this free park initiative will clearly demonstrate our ongoing support for the small businesses on the business community in Wirral, and I would urge Council to support this amendment.
Phil, would you like the word of proposal?
I'm not sure.
No, you have the right to propose, and I have the right to second.
Formally propose.
Okay, and would you like to form a second? The right to reply.
Representative on that body is Anne Nevins. Yeah.